I fear that the old road to Phoenix Gate was lost to the Blight many years ago. Have care out there, both of you.
Harvest's down again this year. Bloody blight.
I'm not sure this harvest will see us through winter.
Maybe. But it's not as though we've got anywhere else to go.
Where are you off to, then? Or hasn't your master told you? Either way, I expect our humble village ain't your final destination. Not to say it didn't have its charms. Take that tower. Relic of the fallen it is. Must have stood there a 1,000 years. And in all that time, no one's ever been inside. Mysterious, eh?
Anything take your fancy? Here you are. Safe travels.
Well met, friend.
Here you are.
Ta.
Come back soon.
Lady Hannah has always been so kind to us. We should do something for her in return.
Yes? What? Go on, then. Is that all?
I see I'm busy here.
What's that for you, dear?
Anything else?
Thank you. Those are Elwyn's. By the flames. You're his firstborn. Clive Rosfield.
You're mistaken.
Oh, you can't fool me, my lord. You're the very image of your father. And that would be true even if you weren't wearing his clothes. The selfsame garments Hannah was keeping for you, if I'm not mistaken. She always swore that she would never part with them until the day Elwyn's sons returned. And now that day has come. Why, you'll be able to take your bearers back as well.
My bearers. Forgive me, Master Mayor. I was a child when last I came to Eastpool. I didn't recognize you.
Oh, I'd be surprised if you recognized anything at all. Much has changed since Rosaria fell to the Empire. Not least for the bearers who once served her noble families. When the Ironblood sacked Rosalith 13 years back, many who lost their masters fled here in search of sanctuary.
And never returned.
Aye. The plan was to send them home once we'd won back the capital. But then the Imperials arrived. Rosaria became a province of Sanbrek. The duchy was dissolved, and they no longer had any home to return to. Back in your father's day, any bearer who lost their master became a ward of the duchy. We'd hand them over to the sheriffs, and they'd be assigned a new position. But when we saw how the Empire treated their branded, we knew that wasn't an option. So they've been here ever since.
And now you want to give them to me?
They're yours by right, Lord Rosfield. Bequeathed you by your late father. And they'd be better off serving you than hiding here. Indeed, many of them used to serve your house and still considered the Rosfields their masters.
I'm no one's master. Not anymore. They wouldn't be safe with me.
I understand. You'll forgive an old man his fanciful notions. Been daydreaming for too long. But still, I would ask a favor of you. A small mercy.
If it is within my power.
One of the bearers is an elderly fellow who still swears absolute loyalty to Archduke Elwyn. I don't ask that you take him into your service, only that you meet with him. Let him see that Elwyn's son still lives, and that he's as fine a man as his father ever was.
It would be my honor.
Thank you, my lord. He sits by the well most days, watching the people go about their business. If you could show him your face, I would be most grateful.
As fine a man as my father.
You're not so very different, you know. Especially dressed like that. Come on. Let's go and meet that bearer. He's not here.
Well, I can't leave without meeting him. I've let the mayor down once already. It would be cruel to disappoint him again.
Right, let's ask around. Someone must have seen him.
Good day, milady. What can I do for you?
I'm looking for a bearer, an elderly fellow who used to serve the Rosfields. Have you seen him?
Ah, that old loon. No, no sign of him today. Funny, he's usually down by the well at this hour, cooking up his fantasy feasts.
I'm sorry?
Oh, he worked in the kitchens at Rosalith Castle back in the day. Still thinks he's there now. You'll often hear the poor fool chatting away to the Archduke. Living in a dream he is. But better there than here, I suppose. Can't imagine the Viceroy stopping to trade tales with a bearer. Can you?
No.
Anyway, you'll be round here somewhere. Doubt he has the path to stray too far.
Thank you. We'll keep looking.
Well now, unfamiliar faces. What brings you to Eastpool, travelers?
We're looking for an elderly bearer. You wouldn't happen to have seen him, would you?
Ah, you mean the old boy who always waits by the well?
Yes, that's him.
What business do you have with him, if you don't mind me asking? You're not from the capital too, are you?
We are, in a way.
Well then, it's a pleasure to meet a fellow Rosalithian. I was born and raised down Market Street. I never would have left if Archduke Elwyn had survived the fire. It wasn't the same when the Duchess took over, though. All the beatings, the evictions, the levies going up and up and up, even as the Blight took half the harvest. Oh, listen to me, telling you what you already know. I'm sorry. I'm afraid I can't help you with your bearer either, though I doubt he'll have gone far. He comes here every day, almost as if he's waiting for something.
We'll keep asking around then. Thank you.
Oh, hold on a mo. Patrick the Chocobo Keeper might know where your bearer is. He's taken the old boy under his wing, so to speak. You should go and have a word with him. He'll be in the stables.
Patrick the Chocobo Keeper. Thank you. We will.
I'm sorry, Jill. Making you do all this in my stead.
It can't be helped if we're to keep up the pretense. Come on, let's head for the stables.
As I said, he couldn't have gone far, even if he wanted to.
Bloody hell's he got to?
Excuse me, but is something the matter?
It's this bearer I've been minding. I take my eyes off him for 1 minute and he disappears. He's not in his usual spot by the well, nor anywhere else in the village.
You must be Patrick.
I am, but...
And this bearer you're looking for... He's an elderly man who used to work in the Rosalith Castle kitchens, yes?
That's the fella. How do you know all this? I've never seen you in Eastpool before, but you seem to know the place better than I do myself. Ah, so that's how it is. Well then. If you're acting under orders of the mayor, you're on a bound to help me find him. He's been losing what little sense he had left of late, saying the sheriffs are coming to collect him and that he needs to go back to the castle. I was supposed to watch over him, keep him out of trouble. But if he's walked out on us, there's not a lot I can do.
Understood. You keep searching here. We'll look for him outside.
Thank you. I'm in your debt.
I hope he hasn't wandered into trouble.
Let's just concentrate on finding him. Still no sign. Could he have strayed even further? There's someone over there.
It might be him. We should hurry. Company.
We can't lead them to the old man. They need to die.
Agreed.
It's over. Lose. Are you all right, my friend? Come on. Let's go home.
Your Grace! You came for me! I waited for you so long, but you finally came!
I'm not who you think.
Clive.
Yes. Pray forgive my long delay.
It's nothing, Your Grace. I prayed to the Founder that you would come, and at long last, he answered. Will we be returning to the castle, then? There is still a place for me in the kitchens?
No, my friend. We will not be returning to the castle, not yet. I'm on a very important expedition, one which may take some time. Could you wait for me in Eastpool. Until my journey is complete, I will come back for you then. I promise.
Of course, Your Grace. For you, I would gladly wait until my dying day.
Thank you, both of you. You've been most kind. The memory of serving the late Archduke was his one light in the darkness, and now that light burns a little more brightly. It's nothing but a fantasy, of course, but it's better than the truth of the matter. A damn sight better. The blight is on our doorstep. Our harvests are failing. The people are leaving in droves. If it weren't for Lady Hannah selling half her worldly goods to provide for the few of us who stay behind, we would long since have starved. We want to keep the bearers safe here, we really do. But unless a miracle happens, we won't be able to spare a crust of bread to share between them soon enough.
Is it really that bad?
So bad, I even petitioned the Imperial Garrison to take them. But when they found out where they'd come from, they damn near spat in our faces. Ducal dogs, they called them. Enemies of the Empire.
I know a man named Cid, who would gladly give a home to any bearer in need of one. Leave this with me. As soon as I return from Phoenix Gate, I'll speak with him.
Thank you, my lord. Will you be passing through Eastpool on your way back? I should very much like to speak with you again, if you have the time, regarding the future of the village, and what might be done for Lady Hannah, after all she's done for us.
Yes, of course. I'll be back anon.
Fare you well, my lord, my lady. I wish you a safe journey.
Deadlands are aptly named.
I didn't realize they were this close.
No wonder their crops are failing. The blight is leaching the ether from the soil. And when the last drop is drained, their fields will turn to this. No plants. No animals. No life.
And no monsters. I suppose that's one small mercy.
What's this? Another relic of the fallen. We won't be able to use any magic here.
Another thing to worry about. As if the absence of ether didn't cause enough problems.
Take away the lad's life force. And problems are all that's left.
I can hardly imagine what this place used to look like before the Blight took it.
I remember. It was beautiful.
Come on, Clive. It's time to discover the truth.
Lady Hannah has always been so kind to us. We should do something for her.
Yes? What?
If you're gonna buy some, be quick about it. Come again. Oh, don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Well? Sangfornian, dear. Anything else?
almost as if time had stood still.
I suppose no one had any cause to return here. No. It's just as I left it. Could I have done this?
Could anyone? What is it, Torgon? Clive.
That's him. He's the only one who can tell me what happened. I have to know. Where is he?
Nowhere to be seen.
Damn it! He's like a bloody eel.
What is this place, anyway? Some sort of shrine?
Oh, sorry. You've never been here before.
This is the Hall of the Gate.
The Gate?
It's a relic of the Fallen. Only the Phoenix's dominant can open it.
Hence the castle's name. This was where Joshua was supposed to...
Yes. He would have stepped through this door the next morning and listened to the words of our ancestors.
Would you have gone with him?
No. The apoditory is holy ground. None but the dominant may enter. I and the other shields would have stood guard here and prayed for my brother's safe return. Where the hell did he go?
Perhaps he went inside.
He couldn't have. He'd need the power of the Phoenix.
Are you sure about this?
Nevermore.
Another gate. Let's see if this one opens.
Okay.
be a fallen ruin.
You could hardly call it a ruin. It's perfect. Like it was built yesterday.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
Any of this. This must be what the fallen ruins were like before they fell.
Ugh! Garuda, lend me your strength!
Too slow. And leave.
Joshua have had to run this gauntlet too?
No. At least not that I ever heard about. I imagine the Phoenix would receive a warmer welcome.
Here we go again. Where will we end up this time?
Surrounded by contraptions hell-bent on murdering us, I expect. Could the Hooded Man really have taken this path?
We won't know until we've followed it all the way to the end. Come on, let's keep going.
Don't let them get away.
don't like this.
Seems the feeling's mutual.
Not this time.
Give them all you've got, boy.
It's done.
What are these creatures? And why do they keep attacking us?
They're probably asking themselves the same thing. We're the ones trespassing here. They're just protecting their home. Jill, look.
Is that some kind of mural?
It's worth a closer look, whatever it is. Right then.
This time.
seem this place holds even more secrets than we thought. Something.
So, it isn't a dead end after all.
Apparently not.
It all seems to lead to this room.
And look what's in it. How old do you suppose this is? 1,000 years? More?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like it before.
Who is that in the middle, do you think? Some sort of god.
You're him. The second dominant of fire. Who are you? I'm back.
Joshua chose me to be his shield. He gave me his blessing and asked me to keep him safe. I should have protected him that day. It was my duty. Joshua died. I killed him.
And I blamed another for what I did. To spare myself the guilt. I feared that by accepting it, I would lose what little was left of me. So I ran. From everything.
And now? Are you ready to accept the truth?
I am. I know it won't be easy, but it's what I must do. So that Joshua's soul can finally rest in peace.
show me who you truly are.
Yeah!
Done running from you. Together. It's time to find out who we are. Once and for all. truth of it now. You are not Ifrit. I am.
It's not your world, but sorry.
Clive, are you all right?
Jill. It's nothing. I'll be fine. No more chasing shadows. The hooded man isn't here. We should go.
Clive, are you sure you're all right? Whatever it is, you can tell me.
I had a hard enough time telling myself. I awakened as a dominant of fire, right here in this castle. And I've been running from it ever since. But now I know for certain who I really am. The second icon of fire, who killed my brother and burned this castle to the ground, was me. Ifrit.
Clive.
I took so many lives that night, and destroyed so many more, including yours. And I must atone for the crimes I've committed. But not before I learn the whole truth. How can a second icon of fire even exist? And why was I chosen as its dominant? Who is the hooded man who brought us here? And what does he want? I need to know. And since I'm still breathing, I might as well make myself useful.
We'll find your answers together. I want to learn the truth too. There'll be time enough for atonement when we're done.
I was hoping you'd say that. I don't think I could do this without you. You never were one to hide from the truth, even when we were young. And you haven't changed a bit.
You're wrong. I have changed. But I don't want to be that person anymore. The things she did were unforgivable. And yet, they're what brought us back together.
Thank you, Jill.
If he is here, then the disturbance I felt at the care must have been confounded. The hour is later than I thought.
Who delivered the coffer said, he said Sid paid him.
I let you run amok with the rest of your rats, and this is how you repay me? Find out where he is. Crush him! Flay him! Rip out his heart! Him and all his filthy brood! And send every last one of them to hell. Out. Now!
Yes! Yes, my lord!
So, what next?
We return to Eastpool. I promised the mayor I'd talk to him again. About Lady Hannah, amongst other things. Though she may be loath to leave, I can't help thinking she'd be safer with Sid, too.
All right. We should arrange an introduction, then.
Torgal, what is it?
Nothing good, I'll wager. Come on.
What happened here?
Imperials! You'll pay for this!
Ah, we've got a live one!
What are you doing here?
Answer me!
Remember our orders? No survivors!
Who would order such a thing?
Stay down.
Escape us, did you, Brandit? You were born a slave, and you'll die one! Kill all the ducal dogs!
Ducal dogs? They
were innocent people!
Someone do me damage.
Stay down.
must burn! The bearers and those who sheltered them. By Empress Annabella's command!
My mother ordered this. Why?
Clive.
I know. You can wait.
Keep your distance, boy. A little help.
Sorry, Lady Anna. You deserved so much better. All of these people did. Better than my mother.
Too late!
Gav!
Clive!
Acting on the orders of the Duchess, eh?
We knew Eastpool was harbouring bearers. Thought they were safe enough hidden up here, but someone must have let slip.
If they'd have only come to us sooner, none of this would have had to happen. Fuck!
My mother always did despise bearers. The way Father embraced them.
when the other nations spat on them as slaves. The way an accident of birth gave them a power that others lacked.
But why kill everyone? They meant no harm. They just wanted to be free.
This world judges that a crime punishable by death. Which is why we're going to change it. Gav, we want to help.
Thought you'd got your own stuff to be getting on with.
We do. But it can wait.
In that case, we should head back and tell Sid you've had a change of heart. He was always on it yet to join us.
All right.
And we'd best be quick. Last I heard, he was planning another excursion.
What about the villagers?
Oi! Can I leave you's lot to take care of things here?
Of course. We'll make sure they get a proper burial.
Thank you. All of you.
When you're ready, then.
Now, rats, lead me to your nest. Lord Kupka's message for your leader. If only he knew where to send it.
Sid Sola, then. We have a lot to discuss.
I heard you lost someone in Eastpool.
I'll fetch you a bowl of brown.
I'm sorry. If there's anything you need, just say the word.
If you can read, don't let Otto know.
We'll put you to work.
It's nice to see the hideaway finally coming alive. It wasn't so long ago us old hands were ratting about the place like peas in a bucket.
Dung had so many uses.
And how might this old soul have said?
I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. What subject shall we consider today?
Always welcome, Clive.
Do you need any help, Miss Molly?
To our friends.
I heard Otto barking at his lot earlier. Didn't sound happy.
What do you suppose it could be?
Look what the curl dragged in.
Go on, then.
Is that all?
Can I see I'm busy here?
What do you want?
Don't mind me, just taking a quick breather.
Can set a broken arm, soothe a cough, settle a stomach. But there is no remedy for what happened in Eastpool. My talents are worthless in the face of such cruelty.
We're low on gigantoad oil and curial greens. Should I put an order in with Lady Karen?
We can keep running. Or we can walk through this door.
This place is getting more crowded by the day.
I tell myself the bustle's a blessing. There'll be time enough for quiet contemplation when I'm dead. So, did you find the answers you were looking for?
I still don't know what to make of this gift, curse, or whatever it is I've been given. But there is one thing I can say for certain. I am a dominant Ifrit. And there is nothing I can do to change that. It is a burden I must bear until my dying day.
Spoken true. Forgiveness and in turn salvation can only begin with acceptance. It's a path we all must walk. No matter how colorful our histories.
Sid, you once told me that you wanted to build a place where people could die on their own terms.
I did.
I've been thinking about that. Why not a place where people can live on their own terms? For 13 years, killing was all I knew. So obsessed with death that I never stopped to consider the lives of those around me. Lives that I see now were scarcely worth living. Be they bearers or beggars, most but march blindly to their end, never realizing that they too deserve a choice. And I dare not turn a blind eye to their suffering any longer.
So, atonement then, is it?
That was the answer we found.
The only one we need.
I'll be expecting you both to pull your weight.
And we will.
Well then, with a sprinkle of fire and ice, this plan of mine might just work.
What trouble are you looking to get yourself into now?
The best kind. We're going to sneak into the Imperial capital and pay a visit to Mother.
understand, the last of our farmholds in the eastern provinces has succumbed to the blight.
Without their yield, we will be hard-pressed to fill the capital's granaries before winter.
If there is a capital by then, the Black creeps closer as we speak.
And yet you do naught but bawl and bluster.
Your Radiance?
If it is fertile land the Empire requires, we need but look south.
If you mean the crystalline Dominion's holdings, we are bound by mutual accord. Theirs is a neutral state whose borders we are sworn to respect.
Gentlemen, did we swear to see our people starve?
Well, I really do think that...
The gates of Oriflam buckle at the flood of those come seeking refuge from the Blight. If there is not grain enough to feed those within our walls, how, pray tell, will we feed those without? But instead of setting your minds to riddles such as these, you lock horns with an enemy from across the sea, sending our soldiers to the slaughter in their thousands. The Empire bleeds, and you sit here prattling like crones in a tea house. And you fancy yourselves leaders of men. Sandbreck is naught without her citizens. We are but their servants. If their land is being wrested away, it is our duty to claim new lands for them.
Your Radiance! You cannot mean a war of conquest.
That is exactly what I mean. It is time we expanded our dominion. This is the will of Great Grieger.
There will be uproar.
Then we must find a way to distract the citizenry.
But how much will that cost? And what of our legions? Shall we raise the furs?
Well, someone will have to contend with the Dalmex.
I will not keep you. You all have much to do. Where is my son?
The Lord Prince is currently garrisoned at the Strait of Arthur. If it please you, I can send word requesting his immediate return to the Holy Capital.
That won't be necessary. Tell him instead to see to his wounds. Bahamut's strength will be needed again soon.
As you command.
I must have misheard. You mean to tell me that the Mother Crystals are the reason the world is dying? Are you mad?
I have been called that on occasion, but no, not today. We've all seen it firsthand. Empty wastes where once were green meadows. Land drained so dry of its ether, not even the rats remained. But where was it all going? I spent years searching for an answer, until I saw it standing right in front of me. There, in the self-same crystals we look to for their so-called blessing. All right, listen. Take this crystal. How does it allow us to conjure magics? Answer, by drawing ambient ether from the air. And where do these crystals come from?
That's easy. They're mined from the Mother Crystals.
They're one and the same.
Although, admittedly, this ear fits more easily in the pocket.
But the mother crystals are massive. Some as large as mountains.
So you see the problem. Imagine just how much ether can be drawn by something that size. As to where it's all going, mind, well, I can't know everything, can I?
We are taught that the mother crystals are divine. Their ether a gift from the heavens. For centuries, nations have fought and fallen for want of that gift. If what you say is true, how did no one else see it?
Who says they didn't? Maybe the truth was inconvenient.
Inconvenient to whom, exactly?
The higher-ups. The gods themselves.
So now you want to do something about the crystals? And what? We're not helping bearers and dominants anymore.
I didn't say that. I made a promise and I intend to keep it. But if we continue down this path, there's only one fate that awaits the realm. And we can't very well set our people free if they're all lying dead in a blighted ditch. Not if we want to create a place where they can live on their own terms, anyway. Sort of defeats the purpose. So, if we have to bring the old world crashing down in order to build us a new one... What say you? Are you with me?
I suppose it's about time I repaid your faith.
You could have just said I. But it's nice to have you aboard all the same.
A few potions for this.
If everything we were taught about the mother crystals was a lie, then what else might we have been deceived about?
I'll give you two a moment to sort out your kit. It's a long walk to Oriflam. I wouldn't want you keeling over on the way.
Enough here for 100, and not nearly enough able bodies to see it all done. The Hideaway is lucky to have you and Jill.
Don't mind me. Just taking a quick breather.
The reports from Eastpool are disturbing. We knew the Viceroyne had no love for her subjects, but to order the slaughter of an entire village.
So gone. The letter.
There's a commotion in the main hall. What's happened this time?
You've lost a letter. Nothing too important, I hope.
Not just a letter. I lost everything. There's a hole in my damn pack, and fool that I am, I didn't bloody notice.
It can't be that bad, surely.
How could it be any worse? I'm a courier. I carry things. If I can't do my job right, then what am I good for? Nothing, that's what. I buggered it right up. That means no herbs for the infirmary, and no fresh meat for our cooking pots. Worst of all, that letter I lost? It was for Sid. A letter he's been waiting on for days.
Maybe if you retrace your steps.
I'd scour storm from coast to coast if I could, but there are curse breakers in the field.
counting on my arrival. No. I'll just have to own up to Otto and Sid. They're gonna skin me alive.
Fine. Tell me where to look.
Are you serious? Thank you.
It sounds like the hideaway could use those supplies. So, where should I start?
Gotan's bales, perhaps? I took a tumble in the bushes when I was passing through. There's a chance my pack might have caught on something. If you can find everything I dropped, you'll be doing us all a favor. And if you can find Sid's letter, you'll be saving my life.
If it's there, I'll find it.
Wonderful. Now, I have to run if I'm to make my next delivery in time. I trust you can find your way to Gotan's bales. Oh, and hurry, will you? Sid doesn't like to be kept waiting.
I'm sure he doesn't. The letter won't last very long out in the elements. I should make for Sambrek as soon as I can.
Now, my research can continue apace. And when my fertilizer is complete, the furrows will need expanding. Bahamil will not bow to the blight.
Come by again when we've grown some fruit worth eating, and I'll see that you get some.
Wanted to send a message, most likely.
But did she have to go so far?
Clive! You're all right! I thought you might be... Oh.
Clive, was it?
Make it quick. So, what'll it be? Scratches, right? And? So, will it be? Anything else?
So what God's forsaken corner of the realm is Sid dragging you off to this time?
Oriflam.
The Holy Capital. And what business would you lot having? On second thoughts, I don't want to know. You'll break your back stuffing all that in your satchel. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. Speaking of Oriflam, I hear the trading routes leading south have seen more than double the usual traffic. If you ask me, something foul's brewing. And it ain't tires, Bobile tea. Oh, just go and see Otto, will you?
All right.
He's never this late. I can't help but fear the worst. Where are you, Randall?
Is everything all right?
Forgive me, young man. I was in a world of my own. I'm worried about my friend, you see. He left some time ago and hasn't returned. And you know what it's like out there for a bearer on his own.
Why leave the safety of the hideaway?
For coin. Sad though it is, our need outweighs the risk. The hideaway can't survive on goodwill alone. And though Karen does what she can, her coffers aren't bottomless. Wait. You were a soldier, were you not? In the Imperial Army?
I was.
Then I ask a favour of you. I'm too old to be traipsing hither and yon. Will you go and find him for me?
I'll do what I can.
Oh, thank you.
What can you tell me about your friend?
His name is Randall, and I suspect you'll find him in Lostwing. He's been working for Quinton, the tavern keeper. He'll know something, I'm sure.
I'll speak to him.
Safe travels, my friend. And thank you again.
The courier said his pack might have split while he was passing through the bales. I better keep my eyes open. Good. Looks like I'm in the right area. More of the lost supplies. He could have fit much more in his pack. Still no sign of Sid's letter, though. We've come this far. Might as well ask around.
A little overdressed to be picking grapes, aren't you? Are you here for Master Quentin?
I'm looking for a letter someone dropped nearby. And I suppose you've seen it.
Can't say I have, sorry.
Well, if you do...
Wait, I did pass a dog with something in its mouth a little while back. Could have been a piece of paper. No idea if it was your letter, but you never know.
Which way did it go?
Towards Lostwing. Seemed well looked after to me. Dare say someone there's been feeding it.
To the village, then. Thank you.
Did Master Quentin summon you?
The shad's all salted and smoked, but it'll be an age.
A whole day on the line and they're still not dry.
It seems we have our culprit. Sorry, boy. Someone's waiting for this. He's waited long enough already. Hopefully this will keep our courier out of trouble.
Sun's setting fast. They'll all be back from the vineyard soon.
Then I'd better go and give that stew a stir.
There haven't been any surprises since your last visit. But we all know how fast that can change.
If it isn't Sid's young protégé. To what do I owe the pleasure?
I'm looking for a bearer called Randall. I hear he's been coming to you for work. He was expected back at the hideaway some time ago. A friend of his asked me to check on him.
Randall, you say? The porter. Yes, yes, I know him. And I can't say I'm surprised if he has been delayed. I gave him enough to do. Though, thinking about it, he should probably have been back by now.
I'll go and look for him. Where was he headed?
He was to meet an associate of mine to the south of here, on Lorbert's Pass. I do hope nothing's happened to him. Be sure to let me know, Clive.
From a couple of the bearers what you did to them royalists over at the care. Glad you're on our side.
Man, thank the gods, you're one of us. We were attacked. Beastmen on the road. Randall knew he didn't play the hero, but Reckless Sod insisted on drawing him off.
Where did this happen?
Further down the road, in the clearing. Please, you have to see that he's safe.
I'll do what I can. You go back to Lost Wing and tell Quentin what happened.
Yeah.
got one.
Sorry, Randall. Looks like I was too late. He doesn't deserve to rot by the roadside. I'll speak to Quentin.
Fetch!
How did the grocer know his daughter?
So it took a tilt between the wardens of light and dark to finally drive the royalists from our shores. Pity it came at such a price. They say the fields of Bellinus were black a full fortnight with all the ravens.
Ah, there you are. My man told me what happened. And? I can't help but notice you're alone. Damn it. I feared as much.
He's not far from the South Gate. I trust you'll do right by him.
Of course. I'll send someone right away. I knew he was brave, though I didn't know he was reckless. Poor fool.
Had you known him long?
A while. I liked the fact that he didn't shy away from dangerous work, and he liked what I paid.
Because it helped keep the hideaway afloat.
I'll tell Sid what happened here. I expect he'll be none too pleased to learn of Randall's fate. And I suppose you're none too happy either. For your trouble. Sorry again. You'll let me tell Sid what happened, won't you?
Otto barking at his lot earlier.
Maybe I should just own up to Otto. There you are. I just got back to the hideaway and thankfully Otto hasn't seen me yet. I don't suppose you,
found the things you dropped. I did.
I was so sure they'd be gone. The letter?
Only a little worse for wear.
No more skulking about in the shadows for me, then. And all thanks to you! Losing those supplies is one thing, but if Sid had found out about that letter...
Is it about Cursebreaker business?
If only... from his daughter. She's off studying in Canver, and her letters are all that keeps Sid sane while she's away.
He never mentioned a daughter.
Well, he's a busy man. And thanks to you, he won't be wasting his time smiting careless couriers with levin bolts. So I'd say you did us both a service. Here, for your troubles. If there's anything you're wanting from Sid, today's the day. He'll be sweet as honey once he gets his hands on this. Sid may be the hardest man I know, but when it comes to his daughter, he's soft as chocobo down.
You'll be champing at the bit to get this letter.
Mind me, just taking a quick...
If everything we were taught about the Mother Crystals was a lie, then what else might we have been deceived about?
Was it?
Take a seat, Clive.
So you're really going through with it? Sid's been talking about bringing down a mother crystal since I've known him. But that's all it's ever been. Talk.
He's convinced it's the right thing to do. We'll be leaving for the capital shortly.
Well, you couldn't have picked a better moment. Seems the hiding the Royalists gave him wasn't enough to dampen old Sylvester's spirits. His legions are on the march again, this time due south.
Another war.
All as the great Grieger wills it. Bloodthirsty little miss, that one. That's God's for you, innit? Still, might work to our advantage on this occasion. Wars breed chaos. On the front lines, and at home. With a fair wind behind them, a handful of light-minded ne'er-do-wells could melt into the back alleys of Oriflam. No trouble. It's making it to the capital that's the problem.
The checkpoint.
That's right. Anyone travelling in or out of Oriflam has to go through Northreach. Lucky for you, I might just know of a way.
This.
Well, no, not that. That gets you an audience with the Dame. And it's the Dame who'll see you safely through Northreach. I'll send the Stolas in the morning, let her know you're coming. We go way back, and she's a true friend of the cause. I'm sure you'll get on like a house on fire.
That's good of you, but who is this Dame, and where will I find her?
She's the proud proprietress of Northreach's foremost house of ill repute, the Vale. And she's quite a woman, if you know what I mean.
A woman. Right.
Don't go blinding her with your charm now, lad. I'll be expecting a full report when you get back.
I suppose that's everything. Now to find Gav.
Oh, you're the new lad, aren't you? Goat at your service. Well, at the hideaway service anyway. Otto's put me in charge of reading through the reports sent in by our allies and picking out any problems that might warrant the attention of the curse breakers. Or any other willing volunteers. And there's no shortage of problems, I can tell you. Well, maybe I don't have to. I'll warrant a strapping lad like you's got people begging him for help wherever you go. Anyway, if you're ever interested in taking a look over the list, just say the word. Reckon you could probably tick off the odd thing here and there. They say little acts of kindness are their own reward. But if that ain't enough, these have got proper bounties on them and all. Me? The way I see it, so what'd you say? Here you go.
Next on the Empire's list.
Don't be silly. We're not harboring fugitive bearers down here, are we?
Oh, thank the founder, you're all right. Well? And you, of course.
Lively enough, isn't it? But then the Imperials came. But the Imperials couldn't have that, could they? Don't you go dying too.
Help us, I beg you.
Help you with what?
Bandits in the Golden Stables. They're waving their swords around. I think they're going to kill someone. When I saw what was happening, I slipped out the back. I should have stayed, but... Oh, please help them.
All right. I'll see to your problem.
Thank you.
How many were there?
I was out of the door too fast to count. They looked a nasty bunch, though. Be careful in there, all right?
Ha! Golden Stables, my ass. All Martha's hiding back here is coppers. Oh, that's a fine sword, friend. Heavy, though, I expect. What say we relieve you of it? Get him, lads. I want that blade.
Let's get this out of the way.
Stay down!
I'll be keeping my blade, thank you.
There he is! The hero of the Golden Stables!
People will think twice about pushing us around again, thanks to you. We're lucky you were nearby. No good cowards wouldn't have dared set foot in the place if I'd been here, of course.
But you weren't. I thought you told me you had someone watching the place.
The Blood Axes keep an eye on the tavern, yeah. When they're not busy keeping the peace, that is. I've spread them as thin as they'll go. The Empire might be in charge, but that don't mean they care to keep us safe. If it weren't for the Blood Axes and me, merchants wouldn't come near these lands for fear of what might happen to them.
I see. Then you do Rosaria a great service.
Just as you did today. You're a useful man to have around. Here.
And there'll be a mug of something tasty waiting for you whenever you next stop by.
Right, we've got work to do for to make this place presentable. You best be going before I arm you with a mop.
Who saw off the bandits, aren't you? Martha was singing your praises. Ah, it takes a brave man to march into danger out of the goodness of his heart. You have my respect.
A Rosarian salute.
Oh, what is it they say? Old habits die hard. I trust you won't be reporting me to the Viceroy. If we'd had a few more like you about, perhaps the Rosfields might still... Listen to me rambling on. Thank you again, and... take care of yourself. Ah, it's just a shame I didn't get here sooner. It would have been an honor to see you fight.
Ah, you're Sid's man, if I'm not mistaken. Couldn't trouble you for some assistance, could I?
That depends. What do you need?
Some new bearers from Oriflam just arrived, and it cost Master Quintin a pretty penny to convince their owner to part with them. Man must have been a bloody tyrant. Can't get a peep out of them, try as I might.
They're probably terrified of you.
You're probably right. Dare say it'd take a bearer like yourself to open them up. So, will you have a word with them? Help them settle in?
I can try.
That'll do me. Tell them they're safe, and that if they need anything, they just have to ask.
I'll let them know.
Appreciate it. They're sitting over there, taking a long overdue breather, looks like.
Grocer know his daughter had been stealing off to the vineyard to see the lad.
There were purple handprints all over.
Master Quintin will never forgive me if I don't save that crop. I want no trouble. Wait, that's... Ah, glory to Grieger. You were the hanged man. I took you for a rogue. If you're a friend of Master Quinton's, then perhaps you'll help me. His vineyard, Lostwing's pride and joy, has been beset by a plague of giant wasps.
And you need someone to solve your pest problem.
I do indeed. I've never seen them so far from the forest, nor so mean, for that matter. I suppose the smell's got them worked up. And little wonder, this'll be the finest crop we've ever known if the fiends don't eat it first. I tried chasing them off myself, but they won't flee from the likes of me. And if I don't bring those grapes in for pressing soon, Master Quinton will have my guts for garters. You look like you can handle that blade of yours. Will you put it to use for a comrade in need? Please...
All right. I'll see to it.
Oh, thank you. You'll find them over at Gotan's Bales on the edge of town. And hurry, Lostwing needs those grapes.
Don't tell me. Turnips for supper.
So you're the new arrivals. Is there anything I can get you? You're safe here. They don't punish people like us for speaking our minds.
Truly. I'm hungry. My sister too. We're starving.
Wait here. I'll fetch you something from the tavern.
Thank you.
I won't be long. You stay here and rest.
That'll be enough.
I suppose I have a moment. What is there to know? When I arrived, yet it is a rare day, and for what? Very good, then.
Can I?
I'll have two plates of whatever you're serving.
Sorry. We've enough mouths of our own to feed without tending to the wants of outsiders.
It's not for me. It's for some new arrivals.
Oh, my apologies. I didn't see the mark. So you're a comrade. Well, in that case, you may have whatever you require. Take all the bread and wine you want.
That's really all it takes. One look at the innkeeper's mark.
Of course it is. I do as Master Quinton commands, as do we all. And Master Quinton commands that none of his favoured guests be left wanting. Well, don't keep our new comrades waiting. Take what you need and see that they eat their fill.
Bread and wine. Hopefully this will be enough.
Did you not say we had new comrades in need of feeding?
Master Quinton says we should build around the ruins as much as we're able. Says that they'll withstand any attack. Only problem is, it means living in a labyrinth.
Don't tell me. Turnips for supper.
Brother, did you...
Here. Bread and wine from the tavern.
May we? Truly? Plenty. Never in all my days.
Brother, this place is like a dream. We sat and no one shouted. We ate and more was offered.
I know. I can't believe it.
You're free now. And the next time you're hungry, you need only ask to be fed.
Thank you for everything.
That must be the vineyard. A few wasps shouldn't give me too much trouble.
Now his daughter had been stealing off to the vineyard to see the lad.
There were purple handprints all over her skirts.
Those wasps won't be interfering with your harvest anymore.
Oh, thank you. Master Quinton would have had my head if I'd lost the crop. I'd say you've earned a reward. Our goat and rouge fetches a handsome price among the rich and powerful of the realm. We use that money to keep our comrades fed and imperial wolves from our door. The vineyards were Master Quinton's idea. He wanted to give bearers a place to work, a place where they'd be safe.
Well, he certainly seems to have done that here. I'm glad I could help.
I'll see that he hears of your kindness. And once this vintage is ripe for drinking, there'll be a glass or two raised in your honor. Thanks again. Finally, I can harvest those grapes. And with the weather we've had, this year's will be a magnificent vintage for sure.
Take a seat, Clive. Good to see you.
Quick look.
Think you can help?
Well, 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 someone's in a hurry.
Just following orders.
Funny, I never took you for the type.
Can't all be as obedient as you, Gaff.
Eh?
Fine day for a little mischief, wouldn't you say?
Is this all of us?
Actually, Gav won't be coming.
Just the three of us, then?
Drake said is the keystone of the Empire. Oriflam's in chaos, yes, but that doesn't mean we can march an army through her gates. The fewer our numbers, the better our chances of going unnoticed. And should that plan fail, well, we have our icons to fall back on.
Sid, I don't know if I can. Ifrit still seems to come and go as he pleases.
Ordinarily, priming an icon comes naturally to a dominance. But then, you are no ordinary dominance.
Well, he's still got the blessing of the Phoenix, doesn't he?
Not to mention what he sucked out of Garuda. And did I ever tell you about how he was once the greatest shield in Rosaria? You know, I reckon he could probably cut us a path out of the capital on his own if need be.
Let's try not to find out.
We're less likely to be spotted if we travel separately. I'll meet you in Northreach in a few days. You two behave now.
So, we're meeting in Northreach. But will I find Cid and Jill before this dame finds me?
But how did the grocer know his daughter had been stealing off?
My children, for we are the chosen, blessed with the everlasting grace of the goddess.
A little help!
Keep your distance, Kurt.
That tower used to be taller.
I reckon they'll be in need of a good mason.
Reach. The soldiers used to speak of a brothel, but that was north of the checkpoint. Dame has friends in the south.
What did you say was in these pies again?
Welcome, good...
Man. Back off, Brendan. Can't you see I'm with a customer?
Give me one of those hams.
Fresh fish, all from the Sea of Grace this very morn.
Keep your hands to yourself. No one will buy anything that's been soured by a brand.
With the right to confiscate any objects forbidden.
The fruit's not getting any fresher.
And what can I do for you? Excellent choice. You've a keen eye. And a fine, fine day to you.
You! Find carpets like this in the capital. I can assure you!
I doubt you could afford even that much of my time. Branded.
My mistake.
No, mine. Upon reflection, you don't have the scent of a branded about you. The flowers. Otto always did know how to please me. More than Sid ever did, anyway. Do you think you could please me, Clive?
You're the dame.
Let us leave such impersonal titles to my less preferred clientele. You can call me Isabel. Otto assured me I could trust you. I can trust you, can't I?
You can trust me, yes, but why would you...
Help you? Because that's what we do. Long ago, Sid did me a kindness when no one else would. I have never forgotten that. Without it, I would not be where I am today. And so, I make it a point to do the same whenever possible. Which brings us here. To the final obstacle between you and whatever it is you seek in the Holy Capital. I fear the guards are not likely to let a masterless bearer pass unmolested. Unless...
Unless...
Unless, of course, his master deigned to appear. Yes, that will do nicely. But I shall expect a favor in return.
Wait, what?
From Dalmechia.
Saw it last time I was through the wall, jutting up from the waves like the mane of some giant beast. I heard tell it's the work of an icon.
Might be she. I heard the Ironblood lost her on their campaign in the Republic.
The right to confiscate any objects forbidden by the throne.
Ciders, Perrys, Murrays.
What the hell are you doing?
Tut tut. We cannot have people thinking I tolerate disobedience from my branded.
The men who gave me this are no more my masters than you are. But it's not as if I can hide it.
From the moment you acquired it, that brand has done naught but take. But today, it is going to give you exactly what you want. Just play along.
Madame, back to the veil already.
But of course, we must make ready to welcome you, my dear.
And who might this be?
Why, my new escort. The streets aren't safe for a girl, what with all the royalists about.
Well, don't work him too hard.
Well, that rather depends on you now, doesn't it? I'll see you all at sunset.
Oi, hold up. Another fucking branded. Well, you're lucky you're with the dame. Now get out of my sight, filth.
That wasn't so bad.
Wasn't so bad. They might have recognized me.
But they didn't. And even if they had, they wouldn't have done anything about it. The gentlemen of the garrison are some of my best customers. We have an arrangement, as do you and I. Now, if you'd care to follow me, we can speak more at the Vale.
Doesn't seem like I have much of a choice.
Seen you around the Vale of late. Oh, don't tell me you've grown tired of us.
It's not that. The garrisons are being called back to the capital. We're to join the legions.
And if anyone requests her company, tell them she is feeling unwell.
Madame, you look stunning.
As do you, my dear.
Shall I have one of the girls draw a bath?
That won't be necessary. Clive, my darling, welcome. To the Vale.
Thank you for seeing me through the gates, my lady. I am in your debt.
Well, that was the whole point, wasn't it? And I told you, it's Isabel. Whatever wound you so tight, I wonder. It's certainly not Cid's influence.
You, mentioned a favor. What is it you'd have me do? I don't want to keep my companions waiting.
If you mean Cid and the girl, you needn't worry. They have yet to reach the checkpoint. Yes, Otto asked me to help them as well. But to answer your question, I need you to find someone for me. One of my girls. Tatienne has been gone for several days now, having left no word of explanation. And I've begun to fear the worst.
I feel as if I've spent my whole life searching for people. Though I can't say I'm any good at it.
I trust you'll do your best. Oh, and take this. Proof of that trust. And hopefully enough to keep prying eyes from looking too closely at that handsome face of yours. Now, I have matters to attend to at the Iron Flagon. If you find anything, ask for me there.
Start here.
If the dame has given you her trust, then you have ours as well. Now you are always welcome here at the Vale.
You wear the dame's brooch. She must trust you.
Enough to help me look for one of your colleagues. A woman by the name of Tatienne.
She's still missing, then? Oh, if only I'd comforted her.
You saw her before she disappeared?
The day before. She was in tears. She'd lost her comb, a gift from the dame. It wasn't anything fancy, but you could tell it meant the world to her. You see, Tatienne was an orphan, and she looked upon the dame as a mother, as do we all.
So she was upset.
and I didn't lend her my shoulder. But perhaps someone else did. Tatian shared a room. Her chambermaid may have seen something. She's over there, sitting by the pond.
Thank you. Let's see what her chambermaid can tell us then.
So you're the new escort the girls have been talking about. And you've already been sent off on an errand, eh? Poor boy. You'll be knackered before the real work begins later on tonight.
I'm told you share a bedchamber with Tatian. Did she say anything to you before?
Before she went missing. Only that she needed to meet with someone. She did mention a name, but I know exactly who she meant.
You do?
Lad from the garrison. Annoying little shit. Spent every gilly earned on Tatian and picked fights with anyone else who tried to buy her time. Followed her around like a lost puppy. Tatian was flattered at first, but it didn't take long for her to get scared. She thought about saying something. But the Dane was so proud of her for how much she was bringing in, and she didn't want to let her down.
This man from the garrison, did you ever see him?
Of course I did. He tried to sneak into our room enough times. Slimy sod's got a scar over one eye. Claims he got it in battle.
You've been very helpful.
Don't let him get away with this. Find him, and you'll find her.
A man from the garrison. Seems a trip to the barracks is in order.
We've all had our share of dodgy punters. That's why the Dame has to hire escorts.
Excuse me, you there, the gentleman with the sword. I cannot help but notice you bear the moon and stars. So you are an associate of the Dame's? Might I trouble you for some assistance? You'll be rewarded, of course.
And who exactly would I be assisting?
Oh, forgive me. I am Etienne, a humble merchant, though fortunate enough to count the Dame among my acquaintances. I have business beyond these walls, but the guards have grown somewhat suspicious of my comings and goings of late. I was hoping someone might be kind enough to go in my stead. And who better than someone in the employ of the Vale's proprietress? Would you be willing to help a fellow in his hour of need?
Why not?
Marvelous. The task is simple enough. Pass through the gate and deliver packages to a few of my most valued clients. There are three in total. A grocer, an apothecary, and a distiller. You need only mention that the items you carry are fresh from the master's table.
Nothing dangerous, I hope.
Why, of course not. Merely trifles which folk beyond the checkpoint are keen to get their hands on. And though I cannot prevent you from peeking, I advise that you don't. Strongly advise. One package to each of my three customers beyond the wall. And remember, fresh from the master's table.
You say these are all from Dalmechia?
There's nothing here for your kind, Branded. Go on now, shoot.
I have a delivery from Etienne. Fresh from the master's table.
Why didn't you say so? Times are hard. But this here'll make them less so. For a while, at least. Sorry about the welcome. Meant nothing by it. You wait right here. Here. You can tell Etienne I'm a man of my word.
Perfume.
Oriflamme's finest. Just as promised. I'd be dead in a ditch if it weren't for Etienne's blessings.
The dame gave you her moon and stars, did she? You think that makes you special? You're only a notch away from being nothing again.
I have no business with Branded.
Well, I have business with you. A package. Fresh from the master's table.
I do not know you. Where is the merchant, Etienne?
Somewhere the gate guards won't be paying him or his affairs any mind.
Fine. Hand over the goods and be gone. This is lighter than usual. Branded, if I discover you have played me false...
I can always take it back.
You will do no such thing. Your master should cut out your insolent tongue. Had you been the tool of any other man, I would see you clapped in chains. Payment. Take it and get out of my sight.
Cigars.
Those cigars are worth more than your life. Do be careful. Speak of this to anyone, and there'll be nightshade in your morning gruel.
What did you say was in these pies again?
I warn you now, I don't sell to your kind, whether you have the coin or not. Where's your master anyway?
Etienne sent me.
Didn't know he had his own bearer. Business must be booming. All right, quickly now, before the guards notice. That is no burden off my back. And this is for Etienne.
All this for a drink?
Not just any drink. The very best, specially distilled for my most discerning customers. The guards find that, they'll seize it before you can blink. You keep it well hidden, all right. If Etienne likes it, tell him there's more where that came from. For a price, of course.
Of course. Perfume, cigars, and spirits. Someone has expensive tastes. The question is, how can they afford to maintain them? I suppose there's only one way to find out.
If I learn you let the guards find that bottle, you'll have me to answer to.
Fresh fish! Whole from the Sea of Grace this very...
You there! Fancy a drop of the Empire's finest?
The dame get her hooks into you then? Well, you're in good company. You tell her, her discount still stands. So long as she keeps up her end of the bargain.
With the right to confiscate any objects forbidden by the throne.
Don't think I haven't got my eye on you, Branded. On you go.
Tatien was... is very special to me. All of my girls are. I need to know what happened to her.
My cousin in the capital said they lost one of the wharves to an ether flood.
It was a good thing they got more than one then, eh?
You! Where the devils who dwell upon western shores? His radiance did command a great legion across the grace for to rid the realm of his stain, yet none did return. Devoured all by the...
Oh, Grandfather, stop bothering this poor man and eat your supper.
Greetings. You are one of the dames chosen, I see. Me? I am but a nameless weaver of song, who would warm the hearts of the good folk of this town with such humble cloth as the muse might permit me to make.
The markets are a veritable meadow, teeming with vermin.
Ugh, you need not remind me. Their incessant chittering is ringing in my ears even now.
Ah, you have returned.
I believe these are yours.
Delightful. The dame will be pleased.
You don't say. And would she be pleased to learn what you had to exchange for those items?
You mean the crystals? No need to be coy, my boy.
Why not just tell me in the first place?
An honest man wears deception like shackles about his ankles. I couldn't risk you stumbling under the gaze of the guards. After all, we both know the punishment for dealing in unsanctioned crystals, even such morsels as I provide. And if you don't know what this day's work may have cost you, then, well, I dare say you'll sleep all the better for it. Despite the risk, our friends beyond the wall gladly give their finest and most treasured wares for the paltry crumbs I trade in.
I didn't realize crystals were so scarce here.
As scarce as chocobo teeth, hence the thriving market for even the scantest fragments. Do you think it vulgar that I profit from the hardship of others?
I think you're doing what you believe is necessary.
Yeah, indeed. And I don't doubt the dame would agree. A reward for a job well done. I have the goods I was commissioned to gather, and the guards are none the wiser. I thank you. As will our mutual friend when she hears of how you evaded me.